First off, I didn't invite Malkie into the group. One of his mittens knew me for years and told me he was having problems, and I stepped in and helped him. He asked to wear a support patch. That's all it meant. He supported it. He was never into my group to begin with. I'll start that right now. Don't have a clue why he's making these accusations, because there is no proof. Never was no proof. And I've been with my wife 25 years now, so really, where does that work out with his numbers, right? But that's that. Bike life that I've been involved in would never, ever, ever, ever do something like this to you. Would never. The people I've been involved in many years that I've been doing it, I gotta say, my family and my children, myself, have been treated like absolute gold. I've never had any ill problems with anybody going through life. Yes, I've got my knuckles cracked, because we all learn and we all take, you know, different ways and different routes and different cultures, and it takes time to get things put together. But there's really not a biker out there that I can say I hate forever doing anything to me, because every one of them I've ever met always taught me and turned me into the type of person that I am today and what I do for everybody. So where I've been, what I do now, and what my future lies ahead, I will always respect anybody that rides on two wheels. It doesn't matter, MRC, RC, MC, you know, in ways I support certain colors. Other ways, it's just life. If you are who you are, as myself, I don't hide behind things. I have no reason to hide. People know who I am, and most of the people that don't, well, they never got the chance to meet me. My past, like I say, they put it out there before. Frank Magazine fucked me over with a write-up, screwed me around, played games, and they put my criminal history out there. My criminal history is not as bad as you think. And they look at me and think, oh, whoa, you're a big bad boy. I'm not a big bad boy, Kurt. I'm just a guy that fucking got involved with that shit years ago. It kept me from fucking being in jail, and to be honest with you, now I'm out of jail all these years, thanks to a lot of these guys in this life, because they do help smarten you up. They don't help you do shit like that. They don't like that stuff. But anyway, that's just my opinion. I'm sure many others have their own out there. I would like to put this out there. There was one thing Malkie brought up to me when we first got together, and he realized that we were in a club. Hey, Pops, yeah, I got people telling me that they're going to drive a wedge between us. No matter what it takes them, they're going to try to wedge between us. Well, if he was that smart and that intelligent as he says he is, and that he tries to put out to be and all this stuff, I guess they obviously put a wedge between us. And where are they at now? Because they don't see them anymore. As far as the public, I respect everybody that sends me the inboxes. I'll never bring names up, but I appreciate the support. I appreciate my friends that stand behind me. To those who, you know, follow Malkie or want to play the game with Malkie, down the road when it gets called out, Malkie can't backstep, because he will lose all credibility that he has right now if he tries to back out of this, which he'll never prove it. He'll never win it. And anybody that knows anything about fucking law, excuse my language, you can find this shit out about anybody. Everybody knows a cop, and all you got to do is ask a cop. Ask anybody that worked in a fucking jail. It's not hard to find out what a guy's criminal record is. This ain't the fucking 80s anymore. So, you know, him and his proof, well, if you got proof, then show it. If not, shut your fucking mouth. That's the best I can tell you. Blah, 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 black sheep. That's, you know, poor me. Well, it wouldn't have been poor you, because you had lots of good friends until you basically made shit out of us.
I miss the days when I had a smile on my face and wasn't so caught up in all of the small things. Wasn't so adamant that I could handle everything alone. It wasn't so cautious and always exhausted, and actually listen to things that my heart said. Riding my bike, just riding my bike, not overthinking my life, not always wondering if I'm a likable person or someone that nobody likes, not always stressing about money or losing my job or scared I ain't making a flight, not always going to bed every night with this knot in my stomach that never unwinds. What happened to me? Yeah, what happened to me? When did I start to believe I wasn't worth it and question my purpose to breathe? Wondering who I should to be. Happiness out of my reach, scared to get back on my feet. Need to get rid of what's detrimental, but it's hard to let go when the thing that hurts you help you get to your dream. See, I miss the days when I wasn't so faded. Love wasn't always invasive, I could embrace it. Just innocent waiting, not always living in anguish. When did I break it? Become overtaken. What was the moment I caved and gave away all of my faith and made a replacement? I miss the days when, I miss the days when.
I miss the smiles we had when we were young. I miss the memories of being in love.
John Haggett. I miss us running. Okay, there's been a post and many people read it today. And they called me out and said this, that, and the other thing. Okay, fair enough. Now, when I was going through a real rough time, loaded drunk and everything, I begged bikers, I begged people, pick me up. The only time you don't pick down on your brother is when you're picking them up.
Give me my mind back. Yeah, give me my mind back.
Yes, I'll remember that. Go back on YouTube. The ones that don't know what I'm saying, just go back on YouTube. You'll see it. My phone started bouncing in the last week. I've been told a lot of truth before it was hijacked. About John Haggett. A place of limitation, always indicating I can't. I've been told a lot of truth from my past. Hated anything it dissects till I'm depressed. I know I'm blessed, but I'm cursed too.
Take me back when I was happy but I wasn't acting. Vulnerable but didn't see it like some kind of weakness or a thing that's unattractive. Had emotion but I learned to mask it. Didn't know what I was running after. Didn't know the older I would grow, the more I lose control and take another baggage. It's really sad when everything you thought was stable crashes. Everything you thought would take the sadness really only made it deeper, got me off the deep end asking. Will we ever feel like we imagined? Will we ever feel like we adapted? Will we ever feel like we did back then? Just take me back when, just take me back when.
I miss the smiles we had when we were young. I miss the memories of feeling love. I miss us running underneath the sun.
I'm not going to ever apologize to John Haggett. He's nothing but a rat.
I miss the smiles we had when we were kids.
Okay, I can't prove that he's a diddler that they said he was, but I believe it. Oh, I believe the guys that told me he was. I believe the men that told me he was. Can I prove that? I got not no paper, no. Do I have on paper he's a rat? Yep. We got that on paper. You want to see that? We can show that. But we all know that he's no good. And I'll leave that at that right there. Okay? I'm not going to go no further with that. He's a no good, slimy piece of shit. Who would want to wear a patch on their back with the president a rat? A fucking rat. And that's a proof. No, I was sent something from a couple of guys. I should probably have never went as far as I went with it. And I say, he bad. Just can't prove that. But I can't prove he's a rat. We do have papers on that. Yep. Be sure to taste your words before you spit them out. Yep. He's no good. Johnny Haggett's no good. Right. He's a low life. He's a sick-minded person. I'm speaking. Spread the love, not the hate. But you don't have to be with them kind of people. I don't care what you're at to people. Some people, it's something that crawls across your floor. To some people, it's got other meanings. To some people, it's downright fucking wrong. To me, it's downright fucking wrong. I'd shoot a rat in a corner with a shotgun in a heartbeat, because I don't like them fur back fuckers in my house. I don't like them four leggers in the house. You got a meow, yeah, you got a cat to take care of them ones, yeah. How do you take care of the other ones? Give them love. All right. Whatever my fans say, give them in, man. You give them love, whatever you guys want me to do. Okay. Me? Huh. No. Not so much. He's just checking around. He is super Christy. He is super God. And everybody call me on it. And okay then. Okay. Well, I hope the fuck keep Retton from confessing someday can go back to me and say, Malkie Woodland, I'm sorry I didn't listen to you. I hope that never happens. I really do. I pray to God that never happens. I'll stand up in front of the world. You can have machine guns on me and I'll say Johnny Haggett's no good. Shoot me. Go ahead, shoot me. exterminate me. Have at her. No problem. I mean that from my heart. Spread the love, not the hate. But certain kind of people.
John Haggett. Okay, there's been a post and many people read it today. And they called me out and said this, that, and the other thing. Okay, fair enough. Now, when I was going through a real rough time, loaded drunk and everything, I begged bikers, I begged people, pick me up. The only time you look down on a brother is when you're picking them up. Just, I'll remember that. Go back on YouTube. The ones that don't know what I'm saying, just go back on YouTube. You'll see it. My phone started bouncing in the last week. I've been told a lot of truth about Johnny Haggett. I've been told a lot of truth, man. I've been